Scripture prophesied the coming Messiah from the beginning. Genesis mentions how God himself spoke of the coming Messiah, the second Adam. Genesis 3:15, "And I will put hostility between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." There were prophecies which point not only to where he was to be born, as in Micah 5:2, "But you, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times." But even to the details of his birth, Isaiah 7:14, "Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel." Prophecy even spoke to the sacrifice that the Messiah would be for the redemption of not only Israel, but the world. Isaiah 53, "He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers silent, so he did not open his mouth." Christmas isn't the entire story. It is about the greatest story ever told. It's the story of the gospel.
Yeah.
In a small but steady voice, she asked, "But how? I am not yet married, and I'm still innocent and untouched." Gabriel understood her confusion. Gently, he said, "The Holy Spirit will come to you, and you will be overshadowed by the Most High. That's why this holy child will be known as not just your son, but the Son of God." Gabriel gently continued, "I know it sounds impossible. You know, your cousin Elizabeth has been unable to have children, and yet she has become pregnant because God has willed it. Mary, the impossible is always possible. Mary, looking down at her hands, she responded, "I am the Lord's humble servant. Let it be done as you have said."
Blessed am I.
Joseph had been battling to come to a decision. As he settled down to sleep, the reality of what had happened was undeniable. Mary was pregnant, and this was a small town. Joseph didn't want to humiliate her, but he needed to end the engagement. Even now, Joseph was trying to find a solution that would protect Mary because he knew what life would be like for an unwed mother and child. Though Joseph's mind was troubled, sleep finally came. As he dreamt, he became aware that a voice was speaking to him. "Joseph, Joseph, son of the house of David, take Mary as your wife." As he heard the messenger speaking, it was obvious this wasn't a mere man. A strong but kind voice continued to speak. "The child she carries was conceived in her by the Holy Spirit. Mary will give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will save his people from their sins." All of this occurred to fulfill the prophecies of God's prophet Isaiah. "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph woke up, he was amazed at what he heard. Joseph arose determined to obey the message he received. He went to Mary to let her know nothing had changed. He would honor their engagement and stand by her.
Just a simple man of trade. Thank you.
quiet, and the stars were bright. Some of the shepherds gathered around the fire. It had been an uneventful night, and the young boys in training were bundled up and on the ground sleeping. The veterans of this group were keeping a watchful eye on the fields below, scanning for danger. As they surveyed the outskirts of the fields where the sheep were kept, they could see the lights from the town of Bethlehem flickering in the dark. Suddenly, in a blinding light and a flash, they were face to face with an angel of the Lord. They stood stunned by what they were seeing. As they looked to each other and back at this ethereal being before them, fear began to take hold. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have good news for you. I bring a joyful message to you. Today, your Savior, Christ the Lord, was born in David's city." The shepherds fell to the ground in awe and wonder, and the angel continued, "This is how you will recognize that you have found him. You will find an infant wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, the shepherds were surrounded by an army of angels, praising God in one voice, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those who have his good will." Then, in a moment, the army of angels were gone. The sky was again dark, and the shepherds were alone in the field.
Thank you.
the shepherds began to all talk at once. They said, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see if what the angel said to us is true." Forgetting their duty to their sheep, they quickly made their way down to the town of Bethlehem. Running down the hills, they were joyous. Making their way through the town, the shepherds knew the child would be in a stable. They were checking the stables as they went. Finally, they came to a small cave used as a stable. As they came in, they saw a young girl half sleeping next to the manger, where an infant quietly lay. A man stepped in front of her, unsure of who all these men were or what their intent was. When the shepherds saw the child, they fell to the ground in worship. They told Joseph the story of the angels in the field, and Mary was awakened by all the voices speaking at once. Mary treasured all that had happened in her heart, remembering what the angel had told her. As the shepherds returned to their flock, they shared all they had been told and seen with everyone.
Thank you.
came into Jerusalem, exhausted, hungry, and wanting to rest. They knew that in the morning they would be ready to seek out the king. When the wise men arrived at the palace, they were taken to the inner court to await an audience. When they were taken to see the king, they had one simple question.
We have been studying the prophecies and we are seeking the newborn king of the Jews. We saw his star as it rose, and we have come to worship him. Do you know where to find him?
King Herod called a meeting of the leading priests and religious teachers. He had been disturbed at what the wise men had said. The king demanded to know the priests and teachers.
Where is the supposed Messiah to be born?
They answered,
in Bethlehem, in Judea, for this is what the prophet wrote. And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not least among the ruling cities of Judah, for a ruler will come from you, who will be the shepherd for my people, Israel.
King Herod met with the wise men for a second time. King Herod said,
I have learned that the child is in Bethlehem. When you find him, send word to me so that I can go and worship him also.
After this interview, the wise men went their way. They continued to follow the star, and it stopped over the place where the child was. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother Mary. Bowed down and worshiped him. The wise men offered gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. When it was time to leave, God had warned them in a dream to not return to Herod, for his intentions were evil.
Feel and find. Lord.